night that Jesus was walking down U Street, and he came to the intersection of New Hampshire and 16, and was walking by Starbucks. And there were 10 beggars that called out to him, said, Jesus, Lord, have mercy on us. And he asked, if you've ever been approached by the beggars at Starbucks, I don't know, I have, or maybe you have, it can be a little bit awkward. I don't like this move. I said, no, go over to St. Augustine's and talk to the priest. Or go to Augustana and talk to the priest. Well, there I was. But go do that. And they did. And they did. And along the way, they were made clean. They were healed. This leprosy that they had went away. And so they went on their way. At least 9 of them did. And they went into Starbucks and were welcome there to get some coffee and maybe a cookie or a pastry. And they went on their way and did those things. But one of them went back. And he put himself, he prostrated. He didn't tap dance. Prostrated himself at the feet of Jesus. And he said, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And Jesus said, weren't there 10? And this guy, this is a Samaritan. This is somebody that we don't, people like me don't talk to. They're tainted. Wrong religion. The wrong ethnicity. They're you know, when you slice and dice who people are, there are little charts that they talk about in terms of the Anti-Defamation League and others will talk about main characteristics that are irrevocable about us. We know he was a man. He wasn't a woman. He was hombres leproso in Greek. He was a man who was leprous. So we know that he was a Semite. He was Samaritan, which means his ethnicity, racially he was a Semite, but his ethnicity was that he was a Samaritan. And we know that Jews don't relate to those people because while they were part of the branch of Judaism, they had not stayed current with the acceptable practices. They didn't go to Jerusalem to worship. They had an altar, a place up on the hill near Bethel. And there they were, did things that weren't true. And so Jesus is looking at this guy and saying, what is with him? Where are the other 10? Well, I think that probably they had gone to the priest and said, look, we're clean, we're healed. And then they had gone home. You know, if you were had leprosy in that day, you weren't welcome into town. You couldn't go to work. You couldn't be with your family. You couldn't do lots of things because of this disease that marked you, separated you, and isolated you from the rest of the community. And that wasn't just from the Jewish community, that was from every community. So it's not at all strange that as lepers, as people with leprosy, that Jews and Samaritans would come together for the only occupation that was available to them in that day, which was begging. And so in this village, as Jesus was entering this village between Samaria and Galilee, there he met this mixed group of beggars who were saying, Lord, have mercy on us. And he did. And he sent them on their way. And they were healed. But this one, the one who was still tainted because he was the wrong ethnicity, he was the wrong person to be coming back, but really couldn't go to the priest, as Jesus had said, because the priest would reject him. Came back to Jesus and prostrated himself at his feet to say, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It's a great story, isn't it? It's one of those stories that over a lifetime, how many times have those of you who are PKs or genetic church people read the Bible regularly? How many times in your life have you heard these stories of these healings of the blind people? And they're always wonderful because Jesus reaches out to the blind or the leper, reaches out and heals people. And it's wonderful. But the one thing that I was left wondering about this time is why did Jesus was saying that I can heal you. I can take away something